I find it hard to be all that I was created to be. Image bearer, to create like God did and stretch my arms to the edge of the canvas till the last drop of paint has been smeared upon it with the same excellence that the stars reflect when they skateboard across the sky. Will I choose to find satisfaction in the things I do and declare them good? My friend asked me the other day, are you not happy because you're not free? Or are you not free because you're not happy? My idea of a well-spent evening is just a couple of friends, good food, and a conversation about eternity. It's good to plant your feet firmly in the ground and let your head into the heavens. See some cosmic realities colliding with veracity and stardust. Really, we were never made to go to the mountaintops of Dharamshala, only to be obsessed with how good we were looking in the WhatsApp stories that came after. We weren't really made to yawn at the sunrise. But then take note that we live on a dying planet, rolling every year into ever-increasing entropy, like a ball of granny's yarn unspooling till there's nothing left of it. Sometimes these songs seem more real than reality, right? But what good are they? Is this fruitful? Useful? What gives this value? Or perhaps I've got it all wrong now. This self-referential cost-benefit analysis of every morsel of goodness I see, maybe that's the reason I find myself caught up in this rut. So unimpressed by life. Sitting in the middle of Woke Town, capital city, convenience commuting, like 100 feet above the ground, but too focused on trying to fill my heart with some momentary mirth on my mobile phone, to notice these 100 souls standing by, waiting for the next ride, to get somewhere, each with a story etched on their hearts, each playing some part, perhaps a girl, dreaming, searching, longing for that something. Perhaps an old man, wise in his weakness, surrendering his former strength now to embrace the tranquility acquired with age. Perhaps even the street urchins that make dwelling under the metro station, way before the minister can come and do the inauguration. I find myself sitting in a myriad of glorious worlds, yet anxious because tomorrow is Monday and I dread going back to class, or fixated on the pixels of my phone that tell me a different story, one in which I am in the center. I don't even want to be, yet I am. The story that tells me that this is the only option available. And before the anxiety can get to me, I try not to think about it too much and just keep scrolling.